When we look back at the long history of our motherland, we see not just centuries, but millennia of struggle, resistance, and resilience. From the time foreign invaders first set foot on our soil, India never bowed down. We fought, sometimes with the sword, sometimes with the pen, and sometimes with the power of truth and non-violence. Our ancestors stood tall, from the valor of Maharana Pratap, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, and Rani Lakshmibai, to the sacrifices of Bhagat Singh, Subhas Chandra Bose, and Mahatma Gandhi. Every age produced heroes who declared, India will rise again. For two centuries, colonial rule tried to break our spirit, drain our wealth, and erase our identity. But the soul of India is eternal. No chain could bind it, no empire could destroy it. And in 1947, after generations of struggle, the tricolor rose to the skies. But freedom was only the beginning. Our nation had to rebuild from ashes, from poverty, partition, and pain, into a sovereign democratic republic. And in just 75 years, India has written a story the world admires, from food scarcity to feeding the world, from dependence on aid to the fifth largest economy, colonized to launching rockets to the moon and Mars, brokenness to becoming the voice of the global South and a leader in science, technology, and culture. This journey is not just about development, it is about reclaiming our civilizational legacy. India once gave the world metallurgy, medicine, astronomy, mathematics. We shared knowledge as light, never as a weapon. We never denied technology to anyone. We didn't even claim it as our own. But the world today is different. Today, the one who owns technology owns the world. And that is precisely why India has been kept away from most critical technology transfers. Jet engines, advanced alloys, nuclear propulsion, until very recently. Because dependence is a chain, and the world wanted India to remain bound. Remember Donald Trump's words? We impose tariff on India. We increase tariff on India. India, India. Why did those words sting? Because they carried the reminder that the world sees us not as equals, but as dependents. Politically, India is free. But technologically, we are still chained. The time has come for a new freedom struggle. Not against colonial rulers, but against technological bullies. Not for land, but for knowledge. Not led by armies, but by scientists. And one of the greatest battles in this new war of independence is being fought inside a roaring chamber of fire. Think about it. The United States guards its B-2 Spirit stealth bomber like a crown jewel. A machine more than three decades old, yet still unmatched. Not because of its shape alone, but because of the engines that power its invisibility and endurance. The lesson is clear. Whoever masters the jet engine, masters the sky. One engine can decide the life of a weapon system for generations, and the destiny of a nation's defense. This is why India cannot afford to borrow fire anymore. We must light our own. Yes, we are politically free. Yes, we are economically rising. But true independence will come only when we are technologically sovereign. And one of the greatest battles in this new freedom struggle is being fought inside a roaring chamber of fire. A chamber that can turn air and fuel into the thunder of a jet. That battle has a name.
Kaveri.
The indigenous Indian jet engine. A dream born in the 1980s. A mission tested in sweat, failure, and fire. A symbol of whether India will soar on its own wings or remain chained by dependence. This is not just about turbines and thrust. This is about sovereignty and survival. This is about the soul of India's second independence movement, freedom from technological oppression, and the power to command our own skies. And at the center of this promise stands Kaveri engine. A fighter jet is not just steel and fire. It is the roar of a nation's pride. And at the heart of that jet lies its soul, the engine. For decades, India has flown fighter jets powered by engines designed in foreign lands. From Britain, from Russia, from America. Powerful engines, yes, but never truly ours. During the Independence Day celebrations from the Red Fort, our Honorable Prime Minister declared with unshakable resolve, India will build its own fighter jet engine. We will not remain dependent.
आज मेरा लाल किले की प्राचीर से मेरे देश के युवा वैज्ञानिकों को, मेरे टैलेंटेड यूथ को, मेरे इंजीनियर्स को और प्रोफेशनल्स को और सरकार के हर विभागों को भी मेरा आह्वान है कि हमारा अपना मेड इन इंडिया फाइटर जेट्स के लिए जेट इंजन हमारा होना चाहिए कि नहीं होना।
This is not just a policy statement. It is the echo of a billion dreams. The promise that India will no longer fight with borrowed fire, but with the flame forged in our own soil. And at the center of this promise stands a name, whispered with both pride and pain for three decades. Kaveri. The Kaveri engine project was born in 1986 under the Gas Turbine Research Establishment, GTRE, in Bengaluru. Its mission? To power India's very own light combat aircraft, Tejas. A jet engine is one of the most complex machines ever built by man. Inside it, air is swallowed at supersonic speeds, squeezed to 30 times its pressure, blasted with fuel at thousands of degrees, and expelled at twice the speed of sound. All while the metal blades inside spin at 12,000 revolutions per minute, enduring heat hotter than volcanic lava. Only a handful of nations, the US, UK, France, Russia, and now China, have mastered this. India dared to join them. But how does a fighter jet engine really work? Air enters through the intake. The fallogressor squeezes this air to immense pressure, like packing a storm into a bottle. The fire spins the turbine blades, which in turn drive the compressor. The jet has raw power. In combat mode, the engine uses an afterburner, injecting extra fuel into the exhaust, creating a blazing tail of fire, doubling thrust for supersonic speed. The challenge? Materials. Would melt at 1200 degrees Celsius. Jet engines must survive 1500 degrees Celsius. This requires single crystal turbine blades, grown atom by atom, without grain boundaries. Requires thermal barrier ceramic coatings, thinner than a hair but tougher than stone. Within 19, requires alloys of nickel, cobalt, titanium, the kind that only a handful of nations can make. Building this is not engineering, it is alchemy. And that is what Indian scientists tried with Kaveri. By the 1990s, the Kaveri engine was on test beds. Engineers worked day and night, pushing the limits of Indian metallurgy, aerodynamics, and precision engineering. But reality was merciless. The engine struggled to reach the 90 kilonewton thrust required to power Tejas. It was overweight by almost 150 kilograms. And worst of all, it could not sustain the extreme conditions at high altitudes and supersonic speeds. Year after year, reports came. Failures, shortfalls, heartbreak. Foreign companies were approached. Technology transfer was denied. The world wanted India to remain a buyer, not a maker. Yet India did not abandon Kaveri. By 2014, Kaveri had logged 3,000 hours of testing. It even powered a Russian IL-76 in flight trials. The dream of powering Tejas was slipping away, but something else was born. Kaveri gave India knowledge. It created a generation of scientists and engineers who understood the dark secrets of jet engines, combustion instability, single crystal turbine blades, high temperature alloys, ceramic coatings, afterburner ignition, digital control systems. Every setback became a classroom, every failure a foundation. Prime Minister Modi, in his vision of Atmanirbhar Bharat, has made indigenous engines a national mission. Later statement was not sudden. It is the result of years of silent preparation. India has mastered single crystal turbine blade technology at DRDO and Midhani. Hindustan Aeronautics Limited has tied up with Safran France for technology infusion. The Defense Acquisition Council is pushing for a 110 kilonewton class engine, enough to power future stealth fighters like AMCA and even Indian Navy twin engine jets. The revival plan is clear. Kaveri may not power Tejas today, but its technology will ignite India's next generation fighters tomorrow. For a common Indian, why is this such a big deal? Because a fighter jet engine is the Mount Everest of engineering. It has to. Runs at 1500 degrees Celsius when metals melt at 1200 degrees Celsius. Withstand 20 atmospheres of pressure inside. Deliver power equal to a nuclear submarine. Inside a cylinder only 3 meters long. Trust your nation's security at 40,000 feet with no chance of failure. This technology is more guarded than nuclear weapon. That's why India's commitment is historic. With its own engine, India will never again stand in line, begging foreign companies for spares. Every warplane, Tejas, AMCA, TED-BF, will truly roar as made in India. Billions of dollars will remain in our own land. And most importantly, India will command the skies with her own voice, her own fire, her own soul. No embargo will bind us. No sanctions will silence us. No foreign denial will decide our destiny. The Kaveri story is not a failure. It is of an unfinished triumph. It may not have flown Tejas, but it lifted India into the rarest league of nations who dared to challenge the impossible. Tomorrow, its descendants, the Kaveri derivatives, will power drones that guard our borders, stealth fighters that protect our seas, and carriers that carry our flag across oceans. And one day soon, an Indian pilot will rise into the sky in an Indian jet, powered by an Indian engine, with the tricolor painted on its wings. That day, the dream of Kaveri will not just be complete, it will be immortal. India has waited too long. But now, with courage, with science, with resolve, the roar of Kaveri will thunder once more. And when it does, the world will not hear just an engine. They will hear the heartbeat of a billion Indians. They will hear the call of a civilization that refuses to be bound. They will hear the united roar of our Jawans who guard, our Kisans who feed, and our scientists and engineers who dream and build. This is the trinity of our strength. This is India rising. This is Bharat soaring, on wings of fire, on power of its own soul. Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, Jai Vaignanik.